Hey everyone, I'm Bosca Wings and this is my very first Minecraft tutorial video here on the YouTubes. And I'm doing this because I posted this beautiful rainbow beacon beam thing on Reddit and a lot of people asked me if I could do a tutorial. And well, I never done one and I thought why not try to do it. So if you're watching this, I obviously succeeded. And if not, I'm just talking to myself and I scrape everything. So yeah, let's get to it. You can see here this nice 48 color rainbow gradient. Oh, let's have a look. And you can turn it off by pressing this button. And if you have headphones on, you might want to brace yourself. Oh. It can get quite loud when I turn it off or on. So if you have frame rate issues because you have to render all those beacon beams, you might want to turn it off. So that's why I built this button to have this option. And you can also use a lever or something else, but you know, buttons are just way more fun to press. So I did this way. And if we press it again, all the lights turn back on. Yeah, and there we go. We have this nice beacon beam from the outside. It looks like this. And I'm going to show you how to build this. Okay, first, let's have a look at the materials that you're gonna need. You have two full stacks of iron blocks. Those are to activate the beacons. So you can also use diamond blocks, emerald blocks, or gold blocks. But of course, the iron blocks are by far the cheapest. And then you need 16 additional beacon activation blocks, but those will be movable. So I use 16 blocks of emerald just to distinguish them and make it easier to build and maybe also follow this tutorial. But of course you can also use 16 additional iron blocks if you don't have the emeralds. Then the big one, what makes this thing so expensive, 48 beacons. And this is a little bit of a grind, so you might want to get your wither skeleton farms running. And I built one recently designed by Logical Geek Boy. I will link the video in the description. And if you follow this, you should have 48 beacons in no time. Then there are 36 structure blocks just to put our redstone on, so you can use whatever you want. So I'm gonna use white wool. Then for the rainbow gradient, you need 6 half stacks of colored glass blocks. And I chose blue, lime, yellow, orange, red, and purple stained glass. You can of course use any color you want, but those will give you the gradient that you saw in the beginning. Then we have 177 chiseled stone bricks that you saw in the previous clip, just as kind of ceiling for the redstone build, but you can use whatever you want or none at all. And those are all the structure blocks. And on the right side, we have the redstone components. We just need one button to toggle the system. 12 redstone dust and 12 redstone repeaters, 4 slime blocks, 21 sticky pistons, and 1 block of redstone. So, the first step, you have to build this layer for the beacon activation. And I'm just gonna put it into focus here. You can stop the video and just build this. It's just one block high, so you can see everything right here. And yeah, just pause it here and then we keep on going. So with this layer finished, we're just gonna drop below and put a sticky piston on every emerald block or underneath every emerald block. And it's gonna face upwards and there's gonna be a one wide gap. So it looks like this. Let's just do it again. Build 3 temporary blocks, remove the upper ones, put a sticky piston there. And go to the next one. To connect all the pistons with redstone, we're just gonna grab our structure block, in this case the white wool, and put it between those pistons on the side and also in this gap on the corner pistons. Just like this, going all around from the center. And then we drop one layer below and just connect everything up to the center. Of course, you don't have to connect it to the center. You can put your activation wherever you like, but I like to have it nice and symmetrical. So yeah, I'm just gonna put it so it all points towards the center. The side ones are done, and for the corner ones, we're just gonna branch off here towards our corner pistons, and we're done. If you want a simple redstone system, you're almost done by just putting redstone lines all on top of those wood blocks. And just do so, put a temporary block here and a lever, and if you pull it, flick it, you see all the pistons get extended, the emerald blocks get pushed into this activation layer, and the beacons will activate, and you can turn it off just by flicking the lever again, and all the emerald blocks will be put out and the beacons will be deactivated. But we want to build the fancy schmancy version with a toggle button, so we're gonna do this, and for this we're just gonna replace the blocks at these junctions with a sticky piston facing upwards like this, and put our structure block on top, and we grab our 12 repeaters and put them wherever our redstone line runs into a block like this, so 3 per side. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3. You don't have to set any ticks, it will work just like this, and yeah, you're good to go. Those are the T flip-flops before that will toggle your beacon. To activate this, you're gonna put some temporary blocks here and a redstone block top and the four slime blocks. And on top of this, we're gonna put a sticky piston facing down. For now, we're just gonna put one of our ceiling blocks, and we have our button. There's our button. And we're gonna put the button on top, and let's see if it works. Yeah, we push it. All those sticky pistons spit out the emerald blocks that are now in the activation layer. And if we hit the button again, everything gets detracted. Now we're gonna place all the beacons, and for this we're just gonna pop those emerald blocks up, and you go around just placing all those beacons. It's 5 on the side, then 3, 1, 3, and then 5 again. I will also show it from above, and then can just pause the video to see how to place them, but it's basically 5, 3, 1, 3, 5, 5. So here you go, all those beacons should now activate. Yeah, there you go. Let's just see that we didn't miss anything, and yeah, it looks good. And you can see if we hit this button, they all turn off. So as I said, have a look from above. Maybe just pause the video if you're unsure how to place them. Yeah, let's see you then. Now we have to take care of the color of all those beams. And to do this, I'm gonna place 4 glass blocks on top of each beacon. And yeah, I will gradually change the amount of one color, let's say the blue one, and shift it more towards lime. And I will put an image on the screen, and I will also, I think I will link it in the description so you can look at it while you build it. But basically you just pick any side you want to start, and you put 4 blue ones there, and then just have a look. In the next one you take 1 blue one, then a lime, and then again 2 blue, then 2 blue, 1 lime, 1 blue, and so on. And you just gonna follow the image that's on screen all around, and yeah, you will end up with a color gradient, and we're almost done. So let's do this. And there we go. We put all the glass in place. And I hope if I push this button, yeah, everything activates nice and evenly. And I think the gradient worked quite well. Let's just see if we see obvious mistakes, but I don't think so. Nope, everything looks great. So yeah, you're basically done. I'm just gonna put a roof on it and see you then. And there you have it. Your beacon beam is ready to go. And you can just push the button and enjoy a nice rainbow around you or just in your landscape, wherever you want to integrate this. And of course you don't have to put a ceiling on top because, well, the build itself looks quite interesting, I would say. So you can also present it proudly and openly to the world. But if you want to hide it, just pick a block you like, put it on top, and you're done. So we're done here with my very first Minecraft tutorial video, and I hope it was somewhat understandable. If not, please tell me so in the comments below, and I will put a link to the world or not in the description, of course, if something wasn't clear in the video and you want to check out the redstone for yourself. And maybe I will see you in another one. See ya!